Hello and welcome back to Suman's Academy. In this video, I'm going to tell you how you can have a good interaction with your students while teaching online classes. So for that, you need to type answerguardian.ch. As you will type answerguardian.ch, you will get the interference of AnswerGuardian. Here, you can create a question according to your choice and student can give the answer whatever they prefer. The answer will appear in the form of cloud. You can see one demo is shown in this. So let us see how we can create our own question and get the answer in cloud form. For that, just click on the plus icon that you see on the top right corner. As soon as you click on this plus icon, you can create your answer garden. So the first one is topic. Topic means you have to enter your question. So let us add the question over here. That is, what are the different types of insurance? So I have added a question over here. Now here you get more options, that is optional, but if you want to make changes over here, you can go through it. So the first one that you can change it, you can keep as a brainstorm. When you keep as a brainstorm, you can get the response of the student and number of times student can give response many times. So it is very good, you can keep it. The next one is classroom mode. When you on classroom mode, the student will be able to give the answer only once. Next one is moderator. If you want to check the answers manually, you can keep it as a moderator. And if you want to lock your question, you can on this lock mode so that no one will be able to give the answer to your question. Next one is answer length. If you want to keep it 20 characters, you can keep. If you want 40 characters, it depends on your question. So the next one is admin password. When you keep a password to your question, you can edit your question, you can make some changes over question in future. So let us add one password over here. Next one is reminder email. If you want to add an email, then it is very good. It will be stored in your email, but I am not going to add an email here. Next is spam filter. Just make it on. And next is case, where you want the answers to be displayed. If you want to keep it as lowercase, you can. If you want to keep as a uppercase, you can. And if you don't want to do any changes, you can go to no changes. So I am going to keep on uppercase. Next one is duration. If you want to keep for short duration, you can. If you want to keep for long duration, you can. And you can also hide the duration, but I'm going to keep for 1 week. And at last, after doing all changes, you can just go to this create button. So click on this create button. So this is how the question will appear to your student. But while explaining, I have logged my answers. So now no one is able to give the answer to this question. Now let us see how to give the answer when it is logged. Just go to the admin panel that you see on the bottom right corner. As soon as you click on admin panel, you can make changes to your question. So we have logged our answer mode. Just I'm going to keep brainstorm because we are going to add many answers to our question. So after making changes, you have to save the changes. So here after changing, you can see now we are able to add the answer to our question. So let us add some answers to this question. What are the different types of insurance? So I am going to add some answers. So as you can see, I have typed the answer and it is appearing on the screen. Now I am going to type some more answers to this question. So this is how you can see I have added 4 types of insurance, that is GECO insurance, car insurance, life insurance and health insurance. Now let us see how to share this question with our student. So at the bottom you will find an option of share. Just click on this share button. Here you can share to various social networking sites that are available in this answer garden. You can also get the link that you see here. Just copy the link and you can paste the link in Google Meet, Google Classroom, Zoom, etc. You can also directly copy the link from the top of this. You can get it and just paste, and your students will click on the link and they can reach to their question. You can also copy the embed code over here and you can keep in your website. So it depends on you how you want to keep the question. So we are just going to copy the link of this quiz, and then we are going to open the link with my demo account. So I am going to paste the link. So here the question has been appeared. So this is how we have opened the question with demo account. Now I know that is car insurance. So I am going to type again car insurance. So what happens to this? So when I have typed car insurance, the font size of this car insurance has been changed, and here you can see we have got two responses of car insurance, while life insurance, GECO insurance and health insurance is only one time. Now if again I type car insurance, what happens to this? Let us see. Again you can see we got three responses of car insurance and the font size of car insurance is going on increasing. Now one more student, he knows that there is life insurance and he types life insurance, then what happens to this? Now I am going to type life insurance. So here you can see car insurance, we got three responses and the size is much larger than life insurance, because life insurance we got only two times, so the size is little bit decreased than car insurance, and GECO insurance and health insurance only one time we got response, so it is same in smaller in size. So this is how the number of time the answer is going on displayed, the font size of that answer will be increased, and you can also see how many students have given response to that answer. So this is how you can create a question and your student, according to their will, they can give the answer. Now let us go to our main account. So this is our main account. We have seen how to share the question with our student. Next option is export. You can also export the answers and you can directly show the result on Twitter. You can also show the result in Wordle and Taxeter. It depends on you where you want to share your result. You can also download the image in PNG form and you can share the image with your students. Next is About. In About, you can go through it. You will get various ideas that are available in Answer Garden, and you can have your own creativity to create your questions. Fourth option is QR code. Just click on this and then tap for QR image. Here you will get a QR image. You can scan the image and directly reach to your question. This is also a very good option available in Answer Garden. Next is local. If you want to keep it local, anyone can give the answer. Just keep it local and then the one who sees the question can give answer to the question. Next is moderator. If you want to hide the answer and check the answer manually, you can do it. Next one is expand. If you click on expand, you can see the question and answer larger in size. Next one is admin panel that we have seen in the beginning of this question. Now we have also submitted few answers with our demo account, but it is not seen here. You can see only one response is seen. Just refresh the page and now you can see how many students have given car insurance. 3, 2 students have responded life insurance, and GECO and health insurance only once time. So this is how you can have your own creativity. You can ask question to your student and the student can give answer according to your will. So this is very good tool you can use in your online classes. I hope you like this tutorial. If you do, just like, comment and subscribe my channel, and also press the bell icon for further notification.